Hello, my friends. Let's talk about Kingdom Hearts. Over the past year, I have spent a lot of time listening to story reviews about Kingdom Hearts and all of the different games, not because I wanted to keep up with the story, get a refresher, or understand what the heck is going on, but because I found that having people explain the entire plot of Kingdom Hearts, no matter who it is, tends to be remarkably hilarious. I even had one of my friends, who is an even bigger Kingdom Hearts fan than I am, go through the whole story, the whole plot with me, and it took two entire evenings spread out over 2 weeks to actually get through everything and make him answer all of my questions. Probably about half of them were unnecessary, me poking fun at him. I definitely made him take more time than he needed to. However, Kingdom Hearts is still a very important story for me. It was very important for me when I was growing up. And if it weren't for Kingdom Hearts, I may never have had the idea to make videos and put them up on YouTube in the first place. In fact, the account which I use to host this channel is an account that I made a very long time ago with a friend from childhood, because our original intent was to record all of the cutscenes from Kingdom Hearts, string them together, and put it up on YouTube as a Kingdom Hearts movie. And to accomplish this, we actually did this extremely complicated process of recording our television screen using our VCR on a VHS tape, and then we were going to use this other newfangled doohickey my dad had got from Best Buy to transfer that onto a CD so that we could then put the CD onto a computer into Windows Movie Maker. And the furthest we got was actually getting it into Windows Movie Maker and getting it exported, but then we couldn't figure out how to actually get it up on YouTube, being dumb little kids who were very new to this concept and had no idea what we were doing. But that very idea, the desire that we were given by playing Kingdom Hearts, is what gave us the idea to make videos and what put that seed, that desire in me to be doing this, even before being a YouTuber was really a thing. Now, people like to talk about how confusing Kingdom Hearts' story is, and I agree, the plot of Kingdom Hearts is extremely confusing, and what seems to be the sticking point for a lot of people is that the idea of heart doesn't actually mean heart, and it doesn't actually just mean emotions. Really, what it refers to is the Japanese concept of kokoro, which is everything. It's a bunch of different concepts that we in the West have separated, from psyche to socializing to emotions and everything mixed together. And if you have an understanding of the idea of kokoro, then just hearing the word heart in what seems like an awkward English context doesn't really feel awkward. However, the plot is absolutely convoluted, but it doesn't really matter. Because Kingdom Hearts is an emotional journey. I'm still working out where to put Kingdom Hearts in my still developing theory of art, but the entire series uses these vague concepts of light, dark, and heart incessantly without any real explanation, and that's because emotionally it doesn't really need an explanation. Light means the good things about ourselves that we accept. Dark means the bad things, the things we struggle with that we don't want to accept. And heart is just who we are as people, and what it means to have light and dark in conflict. Ultimately, every game ends up serving a role in pushing you to think about what it means to become yourself, to develop as a person. Kingdom Hearts 1 started with the desire to explore and explored how that desire quickly goes wrong, while also looking to social interactions, to positive feelings and negative feelings, all of those different things to inform how you grow and develop as a person. Chain of Memories also focused on how memories shape you as a person and at the time that it released, it was hitting right about that time that I, as a teen, was realizing that I was forgetting things that had happened in my childhood in elementary school. And so it coincided almost perfectly with the idea that I could forget my memories. Of course, I'm sure I'm mixing the timeline up a little bit for myself. It may have been middle school, but I think the point still stands. Kingdom Hearts 1 and 2 also had messages of how friends and communities shape who you are as a person, and that theme was emphasized even more in 358 over 2 days. The difference with 358 over 2 days and Birth by Sleep was that more than the first game, it emphasized how sacrifice and betrayal of those friends and the connections you developed can affect you as a person as well. It doesn't define the person by those friendships, while still giving weight to the fact that they do impact you. And coming up to Kingdom Hearts 3, the focus is now mainly on how conflict also creates growth. Ultimately, Kingdom Hearts is just about accepting yourself and the people around you and always growing. Nothing really fully defines you, nothing can be really fully defined, because it's a process, because it's an emotional process of becoming who you are as a person. In the 10 years of waiting for Kingdom Hearts 3 to come out, I have come to think that the plot really just doesn't matter. As much as I'm interested in the plot, as much as I was fascinated about the plot when I was a kid, you really don't need to understand the plot to enjoy the game. The game creates no concrete philosophical argument. It remains vague precisely for the purpose that it can mirror the shared emotional struggle that we all have. Different aspects of different people's lives are going to come to be represented by what the game means when they say light or darkness. Kingdom Hearts just doesn't capture my imagination the way that it used to, nor does it have to, because I'm an adult. I've grown past those times that those games were meant for an audience that needed that emotional development. And a part of me is hoping that this current game is going to respect that the audience that grew up with it has entered a significantly different part of their lives and are looking for some sort of closure to that emotional journey. But at the same time, I understand if the game is still thinking about entreating the audience demographic that it originally shot for, rather than the fans who have grown up with it. I'm not sure which way it's going to go in that, but regardless, I am genuinely excited to get some closure to this story, because the story means a lot to me. And the emotional growth that I was able to develop from experiencing this story and loving this story alongside my various friends, new and old, that I've made over the years, has meant more to me than a lot of the stories that were intellectually stimulating and sparked my imagination in a different way. At the end of every one of these videos, I always urge any of you who watch to stay true. It's the two words that I use to exit out, to give a positive message regardless of the content of the video or the idea that I express. And in all honesty, those two little words are extremely vague. They don't really mean anything specific. It could mean that I'm asking you to keep your integrity and to be honest. It could mean that I'm asking you to support the people around you and to express love and compassion for them. It also means that I want you to express love and compassion for yourself. And at the same time, it still means that I want you to pursue the truth through philosophy, to always be challenging your ideas and never assume that any bit is set in stone, to embrace ignorance the way that philosophy started. In a way, you could say this vague little message of mine comes from Kingdom Hearts, because the game taught me to stay true to myself. And I know a lot of different games have given that to a lot of different people, but Kingdom Hearts did it for me, and it's my hope that in some small way my videos can remind everyone to do the same. So thank you for watching, my friends. If you enjoyed the video, do the YouTube things. I'm sure you don't need me to tell you how to mess with the buttons below. No new video this Saturday because I'm currently preparing some steps that I need to take in order to start my new job, but I will see you next week, and remember, stay true.